How's it going, guys? I'm Soul Survivor 610 coming back at you with another video. Today I'm going to be giving you guys a review of the off-white Nike Zoom Fly. Alright guys, so this pair is not an old pair, it's pretty new, the Nike Off-White collab. I think these are about 2 years old at this point. So this is not the most hyped up pair in the 10 pack, but it is probably my top three favorites, just because it's pink. Pink is my favorite color. I think pink's a manly color. And it definitely looks good on these. So as soon as I saw that off-white and pink came together, I literally went out and bought them immediately. I paid a resale for them on StockX. I think I paid about $240 at the time, which is probably a steal now because I know that they're all raising in price. So I'm going to guess these are probably around $300, maybe more at this point. But without further ado, let's just get into the shoe. So this is the box. It comes in your standard brown off-white box. You have swoosh. There you go. These are size 11. These are from StockX, like I said. It's the paper they came with right there. And they still have the tag on them and everything. So opening up the box, you have, you know, the orange insides and everything like that. More StockX crap. But here are the shoes. So I took the liberty of taking like the paper out of the shoes and I put these shoe tree things in instead because I feel it helps them keep their composure. So I'll take both shoes out. So my extra laces are in here as well as the pretty cool looking wrapping paper that it comes with. Now to get into the shoes. My first impressions when I got these were these are super lightweight, like super, super lightweight because there's really not any material to these. Everything that you see upper wise is super, super thin, like really thin plastic. Not the most breathable shoe for sure, but cannot say that they're not lightweight. So I'll start at the bottom of the shoe and I'll work my way up. Bottom of the shoe, the whole like outsole it's connected to the midsole. So it's all the same. It's this foam material. As you can see, it says foam right there. So the bad thing about that is after like one or two like serious wears, like you're wearing it around for an hour or two, it's gonna crease. The whole midsole is gonna crease. Me personally, I have not like worn these around. I have just worn them for shoots and to just put on my feet. And I can even see like little cracks and, you know, stuff like that happening all around. So be careful that, know that when you get this shoe, it's supposed to look good, but it's not supposed to last. That being said though, very comfortable shoe. I would probably go a half size up. These are size 11 and honestly, like they kind of feel a little bit snug. So maybe even like a full size because like I said, I'm a 10 and a half, but I think I could get away with an 11 and a half for this pair. So going up, whole like, I don't even know what to call it. Like just the material of the shoe is just this really thin plastic, but it looks really nice. You can see the socks that you're wearing and everything like that, or no socks if you're a weirdo and you do that. Like going on the inside, you have all your lettering right there. It's pretty cool. And then I love the swoosh. It's like this neon like punch, like hot pink swoosh, and then you have, you know, the jagged like stitching all around it, and then your little orange flap right there. Like I said, swoosh is probably one of my favorite parts of this shoe in general, next to, you know, the foam right there. You have your little pull tab in the back. It's also made out of this plastic material, and your tongue as well. And then you have the little like Nike sportswear thing right there, and then some miscellaneous like tags that the shoe comes with. So this shoe came with, I believe, just the two laces. It was pink in both, but I kind of mismatched it because I really like the way that the mismatched colors look. So you have pink in this, and then you have the black with this, and then the black comes with, it says shoelaces in orange. Like I said, the colors I just think are so cool. I love when they clash like that. And then your little zip tie isn't the normal red zip tie, it's actually blue. And we've seen that with some of the other parts of off-white collections, like with the women's collection for like the waffle racers and stuff like that, the zip ties were green and they actually almost had like a felt type of feel to it. But you also have your StockX tag on the back, so at least I can say that these are probably legit. Coming from StockX, you never really know. I'll give you guys a good look at the insole right there. It just has the little off-white, you know, insignia. So overall, this shoe is, unique. I think that's the word I'd use. I probably use that for like every pair of shoes, but I really like this pair. Like me personally, I don't go out and I don't pay resale for a lot of shoes. Like if a new shoe's coming out and I just don't hit on sneakers or any other websites the day it drops, chances are I'm probably just never gonna get that shoe. If I'm paying a decent amount of money for a shoe, it's most likely going to be an older pair of Jordans just because I know I'm getting quality, but I couldn't resist for these. These are literally so wild. Also, I really like the orange Mercurials that came out as well. I've been looking for a pair of those. I knew I should have got them when they were still low because they have shot up in price. Literally, I cannot find them for less than like $350 now, but I remember I could get a pair for like $250 or under. So that's kind of just a really quick overview of the shoe. Not gonna make it a super long video. I just wanted to show you guys something special in my collection. Overall, I would say this is probably one of the better off-whites to get. You gotta understand when you're getting off-white shoes, the quality is just not going to really be there on any of them. So this is one of the cheaper off-whites you can get. I'd probably say it's one of the cheapest. If you're not talking about the waffle racers and, you know, the off-whites like that that you can barely wear. Now that I gave you guys a quick review of the shoe, I'm going to give you guys an on-foot so you can see what they look like on feet and if you might want to buy a pair for yourselves. Jones. Alright guys, so that is the end of the video. If you watched to the end, thank you so much for staying with me. If you like this video, please leave a like, leave a comment, subscribe. Any little thing you guys do helps me as a channel. I will be getting more videos to you guys soon. And as always, thank you guys for watching.